I think writing is kind of like creating a special pair of goggles. And reading is kind of like putting on someone's special pair of goggles. Sometimes, when you read someone else's writing, you get to see things in a new, exciting way. When I want to write about things from my point of view, I use the first-person voice. In the first-person voice, my reader puts on my special goggles and understands what it's like to be me. I saw a fierce lion at the zoo. I heard him roar. These sentences are examples of the first-person voice. But what would I do if I wanted you to put on my special goggles and learn about something from another perspective? What if I wanted to tell you information or facts about the world? This kind of writing is called third-person voice writing. If I wanted to explain my trip to the zoo in the third-person voice, I might write, "There is one lion at the zoo. Sometimes he roars at the visitors." When I write using the third-person voice, my readers put on my special goggles, and they understand what it's like to be someone else. Or maybe they will learn a new fact about the world. When I write, I want my reader to see clearly through my goggles, so I need to be as clear as I can. I could use the first-person voice to write clearly about my feelings or what I did. The first-person voice is helpful when I'm telling my story. I might write sentences that start with, "I feel like," or, "Then I said." The first-person voice can be helpful in narrative writing. Third-person voice writing is used for writing about facts. It's often good to use third-person voice in nonfiction writing. I might write sentences that start with, "There is," or, "There are." Third-person voice writing can be helpful in informative writing. Both first-person voice and third-person voice can be used to write about the truth. But first-person voice is used to write from my perspective, and third-person voice is used to write from someone else's perspective, or to explain facts and information.